Hello and welcome to this video on substitutions in logic. This is also going to be applicable to type systems and we'll see how we use them in the next video. So, what is a substitution? A substitution is a map from variables to terms, where mappings are applied simultaneously. That's the formal definition. I think the easiest way to see it is some examples. So, this is what a substitution might look like. We have capital S standing for substitution, is a mapping where, well, it's a set of mappings, here where we say H is mapped to J. So for example, if we have some string, let's say hello, and we apply this substitution on the string, well, then we get jello because we've applied that H to J mapping on hello, we get jello, and that H turns into a J. Cool. We can add other things to our set of mappings. So again, our substitution is this set of mappings. Here, if we add another mapping from O to Y, we change that O on the end of hello to Y, we get jelly. Another thing to note is that second part of the definition. Substitution mappings are simultaneous. So if we apply this substitution, well, the H goes to L, the E goes to A, the L goes to S, and we get lasso. You'll notice that while the H goes to L and then L goes to S, we don't do both of these. So the H doesn't go to S, it just goes to L. So we apply all these kind of simultaneously, but effectively it can only ever match one mapping. In a way, you can almost think of it as being like repeatedly applied. That's not how substitutions work. If it was, we'd get sasso. So actually, if we applied the substitution again to this, we are going to get a substitution basically applied to lasso, because we're just passing it in as an argument again, and we'll get sasso, where this L is now converted over. So that's all there is really to say about substitutions, as far as we'll need to understand them for type systems, especially Hindley-Milner. See you in the next video where we apply these to types. Thanks for watching.